Students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic in the subject, compiler design was types of parsers. So this is one of the important concepts you need to know. There are different types of parsers are present. So here, this is in syntax analysis. These parsers are playing a very important role. Now let's see what are the different types of parsers that are present. The two different types of parsers are, one is the top down parser and next is the bottom up parser. So you have to be scanned from top to bottom, top down parser, and whereas the parser bottom up means from down to up. Okay, so the top down parsers are of two types. One is a backtracking and another is a predictive parser. A top down parser is, one is backtracking and another is a predictive parser. So these two types of parsers are top down parsers, whereas bottom up parser is also called as a chef reduced parser. So this bottom up parser is of two types. One is the operator precedence parser, LR parser. Again, LR parser of different types: SLR, LR, LALR, CLR. Okay, so these are the different types of parsers. So let's see one by one. First, we'll discuss about the top-down parser and what are the different types of top-down parsers, what they are playing a role in the syntax analysis, okay? And after that, bottom-up. Now, let's see a top-down parser. Top-down parser. The process of construction of parse tree starting from root, okay? The process of construction of parse tree, okay, this is a tree, this is a parse tree, starting from the root and proceed to children is called top down parser. That means starting from the start symbol, so S is the start symbol, S is the start symbol, so this may be anything, okay, so it this non-terminal may be E, T, S, whatever it may be, okay, so starting from the start symbol of a grammar. So this is a starting symbol of a grammar. Whatever the grammar you are taking, that is a starting symbol is this. The start with the starting symbol of a grammar and reaching the input string. So the final thing is we have to reach the input string. So what is the input string here? W is equal to ABCD. So we reached the input string. This is the concept, top down. So from top to down, you have to be scanned. Starting from the start symbol of a grammar and reaching the input string is a top-down parser. So the top-down parser is a recursive descendant parser. We call it as a, whereas a back, bottom-up, what I said, it is a shift-reduced parser. And whereas a top-down parser is a recursive descent. The recursive descent is a follow backtracking and non-backtracking system. So the recursive descent may be backtracking or non-backtracking. Non-backtracking comes under the predictive parser, and again the predictive parser is an example for the LL parser. The example is LL parser. So with the help of LL parser, you are going to solve this predictive parser tree. So top-down is a recursive descent. This recursive descent is of two types, backtracking and non-backtracking. The non-backtracking system comes under the predictive parser and LL parser. Okay, so in this video, I just want to explain what is a backtracking. We are discussing the top-down parser. So the top-down parser will see what is a backtracking. So here, you have to note down that in the top-down parser, internally uses leftmost derivation. The main concept here is uses the leftmost derivation. So let's discuss the top-down parser in clearly. With brief points, later we will see the backtracking. The top-down parser internally uses leftmost derivation. So leftmost derivation. Okay, it uses the leftmost derivation, and top-down parser constructed further grammar if it is a free from ambiguity and left recursion. So when you construct the top-down parser, so this top-down parser constructed, it is constructed further grammar. For which grammar it will be constructed? Grammar if it is Free from ambiguity. Free from ambiguity. And left recursion. So when that grammar is free from ambiguity and the left recursion, then only the top down parser will be constructed. If there is no ambiguity in the tree, then we can construct the top down parser. The average time complexity here is order of n square. Okay, the different classifications of top down parser is, let me tell you. So still we didn't enter into the different types of top down parser. We are discussing only the top down parser. The different classifications of top down parser is with backtracking. So I said the top down parser is of two types, with backtracking and without backtracking. Without backtracking. Okay, so with backtracking is an example for the brute force technique. Okay, with backtracking is an example for brute force technique, and without backtracking is predictive parser. The predictive parser is parse the tree without using the backtracking concept. Predictive parser. Okay, again this predictive parser is LL of one grammar. It uses LL of one grammar and recursive descent parser. Okay, so this is about the classification of top-down parser. So let me clearly explain what is a recursive descent. Okay. Here the recursive descent is of backtracking and non-backtracking, both the concepts will use. So let's see what is a recursive descent. So up to now what I explained, what is a top-down parser, how the grammar will be constructed. So with the help of the grammar, by using the starting symbol, you need to parse the tree. Okay, so S is A, B, C. In place of A, just substitute B, C, and in place of B, you substitute D. With the terminals, the non-terminals will be replaced with the terminals, and you have you have to follow the top-down process. So the top-down process is of two types, backtracking and non-backtracking. So it uses a recursive descent concept. Now let's see what is a recursive descent. Later we will see what is a backtracking and without backtracking technology. Recursive descent parsing. So what is a recursive descent parsing? So actually, under this technique, this recursive descent technique, the parser is constructed from top to down. So because it is a top down parsing, so it will the parse is conducted from top to down, and the input is read from left to right. Okay, parse is constructed from top, and input is read from left to right. Input is read from left to right. Left to right, the input is read from recursive descent. The producers for every terminal, so whatever the terminal that is, it produces for every terminal and non-terminal entity are used. So here the productions, whatever the productions are there, okay, for every terminal and non-terminal entities are used in recursive descent parsing. So here the input is recursively pursued. Let me write. The input is recursively parsed. So whatever the input that we are taking, so that input is recursively parsed by this technique for preparing a parse tree. For preparing a parse tree. So actually, what we, the aim of our recursive descent, we have to construct the parse tree. So the input is recursively parsed for preparing a parse tree with or without backtracking. So it may follow with or without backtracking. So that is as I said, the recursive descent may be a backtracking or non-backtracking. So it is a top-down approach. So here, what the main aim of recursive descent? The input is recursively parsed. So whatever the input that we are taking, okay? So this grammar, whatever the input that we are taking, that input is recursively parsed for preparing a parse tree. For preparing a parse tree with or without backtracking. So it may follow with backtracking or without backtracking. The aim is to prepare a parse tree. But backtracking cannot be avoided for the associate grammar. And whereas a predictive parsing is the recursive parsing without backtracking. So backtracking may uses, here the backtracking concept will be used to parse the tree recursively, and without backtracking means we use the predictive parsing technique. So with the help of predictive parsing technique, we are parsing the tree recursively but without backtracking concept. Okay, so this is about the introduction part of the top-down parser and what is a recursive descent, why we are using the recursive descent. Actually, the recursive descent is used to parse the tree with or without backtracking. We have to prepare the tree by taking the input with or without backtracking. Thank you.